to go.
Yeah, good morning, great students of Better Fit Group of Schools. This is Better Fit e-learning platform. My name is Mr. Ehime Ujoyi, your English tutor. This is for SS2 and SS3. For SS2, it's yours, but for SS3, it starts as what? A revision. Today, we want to look at vocabulary development. Reservative preferences. Reservative preferences. Now, what is a preference? If you are to ask, what is a preference? A preference is a word, element added to a base or root. Every word has a base or root. Are we together? So, at the beginning, it gives another word. Preferences do not generally change or alter the word, class, of the base or root. What it does is, the word has suffixes do, but they do not change the meaning. What are we talking about in a nutshell? You know, when you say a word as a base, it's a word that is standing on its own, but it needed another word to be added to it to make a complete sense. Example. Example. We have the word called fair. Are we together? We have the word called fair. This fair is a root word and it's a base word. How is it a root word and how is it a base word? Very simple. It's a word on its own, standing on its own. Okay? Now, if you agree with me that a prefix is a word element added to the base of the root, and I just told you from this example, the word fair is a root word and a base word. Are we together? So what do we do? Or what do we add to it to give us a prefix? Then you now have something like UN, on. Okay? When UN is added, you now have the word on fair. Are we together? When UN is added to the root word or to the base word, it now becomes what? Unfair. That is why I can make a statement. It is drastically unfair, comma, the way the government is treating the populace. It is drastically unfair the way the government is treating the populace. Now, when you look at this, this unfair here serves as what? A measure to the beginning of the sentence and to the completion of the sentence. That is what is known as what? A prefix. Okay? It is drastically unfair the way the government is treating the populace. Now, let's say, for example, we remove this word, unfair. We'll have it as, it is drastically the way the government is treating the populace. You do not need a soothsayer to tell me that this is a tautology. Why? There's no sense. It is drastically the way. Even a layman on the streets will laugh at you at this level. So what is the bridge? It's what? The unfair. That is why we say unfair. Fair as a word is a root word. On its own, it is standing. But when you now add an additional word, like UN, it makes it what? A prefix. So now when we move on again, we begin to look at tabulated the prefix, the meaning of the prefix, the base stroke root word, and the new word it formed. Let me tell you something. One thing you should know at this level is every preference is an addition to a word that will make what sense. Okay? It's an addition to a word, and that word is a root word. When you add a prefix to it, it now makes sense to you. Now, number one here, we have uni and we have mono. What does that connote? You know that uni means one, and also mono means one, isn't it? Now, we have a word, a base word. This is a base word, lateral. Are we together? This is log, and this is theism. Okay? Theism, log, and lateral are base words. They are on their own. You don't need, even if you add another word or you don't need to add another word, the thoughts make complete sense. But because we are looking at the reservative prefixes, we want to add a prefix to this word so that when we are using it in the context of the sentence, it will not make sense. Now, when we add uni to lateral, what do we have? Unilateral. For those of you that do mathematics, I know there's a triangle, you say unilateral what? Triangle. Have you bothered to ask, well, why a twin word? The twin word is as a result of the additional preference added to the word lateral. So also, we have log. Then we now have what? Monologue. For my literature students, they understand this better. A monologue. Okay? Monologue simply means one actor, one person. Okay? A monologue. Then theism. The word theism means God. Okay? The word theism means God. Are we together? So when we now say monotheism, it means one God. We also have polytheism, and one of you will get to that aspect. But since it's one, this means one God. Okay? Say, I am a monotheist, which means I worship only what? One God. Then number two, we have the bi, the di, and the da. What does it connote? What does it mean? It means two. Bi means two, di means two, and da means what? Two. Moving on, what do we have? We have lingual, enya, ama, po, and lo. Are we together? Now, when you now merge this, on this particular one alone, it doesn't really make sense to you, but it has a meaning, but it doesn't really make sense when you're pronouncing it. But now, when you begin to add the prefix to it, let's start with the bi. We added bi to lingua. We now have what? Bilingual. What does that mean? It means I can speak more than one language. You say, fortunately enough, I am privileged to be what? A bilingual. You say, that uncle just speak grammar. No! I'm just telling you I can speak just two languages. Are we together? Then we now have die. Okay? We now have die. Well, we have dipo. Okay? Then we now have our da, where it comes in terms of what? Dialogue. What does it mean to dialogue? To have a conversation between one or two persons. You know this, which is what? Biennial. For those of us that do a break, then you know what is what? Biannual. Alright? Then we now have the tri, which stands for what? Theory. It is what? Partity. Angle. Okay? Now, when you say try, it's three. Okay? And when you add this try to this partit, or partity as you want to call it, we call it triparty. In labor laws, Nigerian Labor Congress, it's what we call triparty conversation. between among three persons. Okay? Let's say, for example, there is a strike action. The strike action is between the Nigerian Labour Congress interceding, the resident daughters also interceding, and the government. That is a tri-party organization or a tri-party meeting. Three group of people, three aggrieved people trying to work, settle something. Then you have angle. When you add tri to this, you know what a triangle means. A three-sided word, angle, isn't it? A triangle, a triangle. Now, we now have a mortar, what do we call morti? I'm telling you, we have a mortar, and we have a poly, okay? It means many, okay? Then we have the base word, racial, lingual, syllabi, atomic, Ghani, and G, okay? Then you now say polyatomic. What does that mean? Many weapons. When you say atomic bomb, say that was a polyatomic detonation of bombs. Okay? More than what you can count. Then you now have polygamy. Okay? You know what polygamy is? Okay? The marriage of a woman to two husbands, a man to two wives, polygamy. Then you have polyandry. The reverse is the case of polyandry. Polygamy means one man, two wives. Polyandry, one woman, two husbands. Are we together? Then we now have polytechnic. Okay? It means an institution that have more than one technical department. An institution that has many technical words departments. So when you look at it in a holistic perspective, you'll discover that despite a base word is there, it is the prefix that gives it meaning. So that when you are making a cluster statement, it will make sense to you. Are we together? So there are more prefixes that I'll be looking at today. There are more prefixes that we will be looking at subsequently. But for the course of this e-learning teaching, I just want to introduce you to what is meant by what? Relative prefixes, and what it meant for us to also connote or denote what it also has in store for us. But I want to stop here for today. Ceteris paribus, all things being equal, I'll be with you next time. Remain ever blessed and stay put.